If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hello everyone, Melkadrian here, and I'm here to show you Mystic Bell, an adventure action platformer. And mind you, this is a really fun game when I played it. I played it and I finished it, and I had fun playing through it all. And I'm going to show you a bit of this game today. See, there's my complete profile right there. Anyways, I'm gonna start with a clean profile so you can get some backstory. One cold late October night, freshman student of the Hagmore School of Witchcraft, Belle McFay was just minding her business, practicing her entry-level and fire magic in a shadowy hallway outside her dorm. A sudden chill and a deafening clang of doors flying open startled her. A dark finger darted past Belle, almost but not quite running into her. Before our poor Belle could think of anything witty to yell at the dark who just knocked her off her feet, a strong grown-up had grabbed her ear, and a cranky old voice said, "Young Lady McFay, you're in so much trouble." Look at that art. "So, what do you got to say for yourself, young lady?" "What did I do? I seriously had no idea what this is about." "Don't play dumb with us, whippersnappers. You've ruined the Walpurgisnacht brew with one of your infernal fire spells." "Infernal, I tell ya." "Oh crap, the brew is ruined. But how could my fire spell interfere with it? Or did you just blame me because I was hanging around in the hallway? Come to think of it, I have actually seen something, or rather someone." "Silence, insolent child! You are guilty, and that's the end of it. You can either atone for your transgression or be expelled from this school at once. Your choice." "So freaking typical." "Fine, I'll fix the brew. What do I need?" "Good, the council accepts your plea. In order to restore the brew, you must find these three items. The Bloom of Twilight, a Claw of a Werewolf, and a Dragon Scale." "Dragon Scale? A Claw? Really? Where am I going to get this stuff, especially on a short notice?" "That, young lady, isn't our concern, but I would suggest looking for some of those items in the dark forest." "Yes, but some might be found within the walls of this very school."
"Yes."
"Be careful, girl. Walpurgisnacht is dear, and the spirits are restless. The danger awaits you around every corner."
"Fantastic. Just expel me now. This sounds utterly insane."
"Miss Willow, your homeroom teacher who bears responsibility for the actions of all her students, will be working on the brew along with you. Go see her first."
Now we get our first item. Now this game plays... how do I put this? What was that game back in the Amiga days? The one with the spinning egg guy. Basically, part of the mechanics for inventory management is basically from that. You have a limited inventory space. You can pick up items, and you only have a certain amount of space you can put in your pockets. "You're in luck, girl. The Bloom of Twilight can only be found during full moon around Walpurgisnacht. It blooms in the shade of the oldest tree in the forest."
"Thanks."
See? Exclamation point. Now we can talk to someone.
"Dumb girl, what have you done?"
"But I really didn't do anything."
"I guess that makes no difference now."
"Yes, it does. I don't want to get expelled for something I didn't do. If the potion isn't restored in time, it wouldn't even matter."
Let's see, it's been a while. Let's see, jump, fire your fire spell. That's the only weapon you have, a fire spell. However, you can make your fire spell stronger. All you need to do is kill a lot of enemies. Now, mind you, there's that mini-map in the corner. The game pretty much plays like a Metroid game. Except that, well, it isn't exactly a Metroid game. You don't pick up power-ups that aren't permanent. Well, you don't have any missiles or any bombs like that. But you do have permanent power-ups. Look at all the witches in the background. Let's see. "Being a proper young witch, you must be take responsibility for your misdeeds. But I didn't do it. Surely you must realize that on some level."
Good dialogue. Let's see. Here we go.
The hall pass.
We just dropped it.
Anyways, the hall pass is an apple.
Unfortunately, the apple is not exactly it's not exactly food. Anyways, let's talk to this green scaly thing. Where does it think it's going? No hall pass? Can't go. Well, here. Here's my hall pass. Oi! That's the ticket? Firehair don't leave past anywhere, or he will come. Who's he? No joke, he, hall monitor. Yeah, the hall monitor really is something you do not want to, encounter. Unless you have a lot of health. Or really need to have a lot of, well, really need to have that one single inventory space. I love the art style in this place. I mean, look at all the effort it took, mostly, to drop this single room. Now, mind you, some of it's probably tiled, but it's just, it really is well made, especially when it comes to the walking animation. You're wondering why she has a broom and she's not flying on it. Well, she requires a power-up in order to use it. She can use it, but she just can't exactly use it right now. She needs a power-up to make use of the broom. Let's see. Ooh, what do we have here? This is a huge yellow tank full of toxic weed killer. Weed killer, huh? Oh, and enemies respawn in every room. Good for those who want to level up your fire magic very quickly. Anyways, this is a portal room. I've been told this is a travel mirror. It's used for quickly getting around the school, but only if one knows where the other ones like it are located. Unfortunately, this is the only one I know of. Yes, this will be the one that you will be using a lot to travel around the place, because let's just say if you get defeated, you're sent back to the, how do I put it, the witch council room, the trial room, basically where you first began, and you will keep respawning forever back there. But there are save points. And I believe, if I remember right, the save points are the travel mirrors. Anyways, Miss Sky Willow Study. Oh, Belle, what have you done? Madam Hagmore is furious, and we're almost out of time to recreate the brew. Miss Willow, please believe me, I had nothing to do with this. I was just practicing in the hallway. There was some crazy clatter and some jerk almost knocked me off my feet. The next thing I know, I'm being dragged into the council chambers. This changes everything. Why didn't you tell that to the council? I could barely get a word in. They seem to have made up their mind even before I opened my mouth. Well, this is bad. Not only do we have to get all these rare ingredients, but watch out for whoever sabotaged the brew in the first place. Either way, be careful, Belle, and be sure to bring me the ingredients as you find them. I'll try to help you as much as I can. But the Walpurgisnacht brew requires me to constantly keep an eye on it. Yeah. While she is constantly working on the brew, you can at least get some, get some information out of her by showing her items. Like this hall pass. Yeah, fake apple or not, keep the thing at you all times. You never know when you run into a hall monitor. Let's take this. Yeah, we have to go to this through that same dialogue in order to show another item again and again. Hey, that's mine! Desperate times, desperate measures, Miss Willow. I totally need it. For stuff, I guess. Well, make sure you don't go spraying poison all over the school. Unfortunately, in order to progress through some places, like here, we're going to need to do so. Alright. When the enemies get close to Belle, she just whacks them with her broom. Deals more damage that way. If you ever want to know about, if you ever were curious about that, whether it would deal more damage when you're close to an enemy or not. I'm kind of beat up. Oh, leveling up does increase your maximum health, if you're wondering about that. Anyways, I remember the people who, there's a bit of history when it comes to this game, at least to me. Now, mind you, a couple years ago, I actually did an impressions video of a Kickstarter video called, I think it was Legend of Iria? It's something like that. Anyways, the people who are making that game also made this game. Yeah. There's no way I can lug the whole thing with me, but if I happen to find a spray pump, I could fill it here. But yeah, they made this game as well. So, at least they're doing something with their time while they're working on the full feature length. Now, mind you, this will take up a fair chunk of time trying to figure things out, puzzling things around. Oh, and mind you, there are items that are actually junk items. So if you're just carrying those around, they're just good luck. It's useless. Don't bother. Anyways, let's fill our spray pump with some deadly toxic gas or herbicide, because we need it for something in a moment. And we can actually show this off to Miss Willow to see what sort of dialogue she'll have next. Nah. Gonna kill it. My spray can, full of poison. Make sure you don't kill anyone or anything important with this. Yeah. We're gonna have to kill something. I'm not sure if it's gonna be important, mind you, because... Well, anyways. This mop has turned orange after one too many magical accident cleanup. It could even pass for some punky hairdo. Well, maybe from a distance, in a dark room, while blackout drunk. Unfortunately, we can't do anything with it, so... Let's see. The sign reads, warning, approaching the carnivorous plant will result in instant death and expulsion from the school. No, carnivorous plants are magic proof, shooting it will only make it angrier. Not only is it magic proof, but the magic just bounces right off them. Not to worry, we can take care of that. Here, have some weed killer. Haha. Now we got something out of it, a stinky leaf. And a stinky leaf is actually pretty useful, if I remember right. As well as the nail clippers. The nail clippers is really important. Do not lose those. You'll sometimes have to figure out which one is a junk item, which one is not. This, however, is rubbish. It really is rubbish. Don't bother carrying it. Also, the good thing is that the items that you have placed, they're marked, as you can see on the map with the white dot. So if you place place an item right here, it'll be a dot in this room. Now, mind you, it's probably a good idea to collect everything and put it in a place where it's easy to access. My recommendation, put it right next to a travel mirror. Alright, we have another person we could speak to. Hey, Nikki, what are you doing here so late? Late? Oh, I guess that really is. This book is freaking great. Oh, well, I guess I'll just finish it. Can you help me look for some brew ingredients, like a fun scavenger hunt type of thing? Sorry, Belle, you know I'm useless when it comes to real-world stuff. In fact, I might be allergic to scavenger hunts, and possibly fun. Yeah, right, you're having fun right now, reading that book. She just doesn't want to help out. Well, she'll probably help out at a later time, but not right now. Ooh, shiny knob, and we get an exclamation point. This looks like someone tried to break off a piece of this curtain rod, but failed miserably. Ah yes, this room. Exploding drops of pain. And flying pork. Ghost pork at that. Who... That's just a funny design idea. Flying ghost pork. Would you like a flying ghost pork? Sure, that sounds delicious. Hey, I can't eat it. That's because it's a flying ghost pork. Also, it's flying out the window. Most of the time you'll be interacting with people and basically puzzling out what you need to do in order to, well, solve the puzzle to continue forward. Most of the time it's not, finding missiles or blowing up this secret passage. As far as I know, there aren't exactly any secret passages at all. At least none that I can remember. Mind you, it's been a while since I've actually last played this game. Oh, hello there, kitty. I want to show this off. It's midnight. Miss Willow's adorable kitty. Can't resist the cuteness. Must pet kitten. Holy cow, this rubble over here has one heck of a static charge on it. Yes. Miss Willow's kitty has a really powerful static charge. You can probably use it as batteries. If it doesn't burn out your electronic device, we'll add it. And mind you, this is actually a puzzle item. A puzzle object. Yeah, everything and anything has a sort of puzzle to it that can be figured out. Such as taking this, flimsy piece of chain. Yep, flimsy chain. Now this person will have to reach higher to, activate the latrine. This place really has some old latrines. Anyways, what do I think about Mystic Bell? When I played it, it was fun. I had fun puzzling, figuring things out, and basically reading the dialogue. There's a lot of witty dialogue in this game. Now, there is one little gripe that I have with this game. It's minor, but it may not be minor to you guys. There is one ability in this game that has a stiff control to it. You'll find out when you get to it, but maybe you have a better chance of actually using it better than I can, but for me, I have to mash the arrow keys repeatedly in order to actually use it properly. That's my gripe, and, well, I'll just leave it at that. Anyways, Mystic Bell, fun game. If it's something that you guys like, I recommend you guys at least check it out. I mean, I had fun. So until next time, this is Melkadrian, and I'm signing off. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day, and happy gaming. Also, the music's fantastic. Has that sort of Amiga feel to it.